Dogs have been used by the Australian Army, really dating back to Vietnam.
Over that period of when I was in Afghanistan, I spent more times with my dog than I did my own family.
You might start to think of them as a colleague right at the beginning, but definitely that dog does become your best mate overseas.
This is something that we as dog handlers have wanted for a long, long time.
This is Nova. We managed to have her cremated. I got to bring her back from Afghanistan.
They put their lives on the line and we essentially put our lives in their paws.
Since the 1970s, dogs have trained alongside Australian soldiers and served in some of our toughest conflicts. From Vietnam to Iraq and Afghanistan, dogs have been there the whole way.
We'll kick it, kick it.
He looks like a family pet, but Bundy is a 13-year-old Afghanistan war veteran. He worked as a highly skilled explosive detection dog.
Bundy and I were deployed to Afghanistan in 2011, December 2011. So we were there for 10 months. In that time, we served over two separate rotations. Our role over there is search. We're at the front to pick up the explosives or caches before anyone else gets there or gets injured along the way. Bundy's role is very crucial overseas. They saved countless lives. It is like having a colleague, a very well-respected colleague.
During their deployment, Reuben and Bundy became pretty close. At one point, they spent 2 months in a remote outpost sharing a tent and sometimes a little more.
I love beef jerky, and obviously being a dog, so does he. I went out to do my watch once. And I came back and I had nearly 2 kilos of beef jerky missing. Yeah, and the dog had eaten it all. The next day, it was Bundy had the runs for quite some time. The relationship got a little bit strained there, but you definitely get very attached to the dog overseas. You know, you've got human contact, but definitely that dog does become your best mate.
Sit.
Pull. This is the school where Bundy learnt the ropes. It opened back in the 1960s to train dogs for Vietnam.
Boy.
Today, Reuben and the other trainers are testing some new recruits.
They need to be bold but not aggressive. They need to be able to go on all sorts of surfaces.
Get up, mate. Oi, come on, mate.
We look for dogs that have a really high fanatical drive for the tennis ball.
The dogs are often mixes of the breeds seen in other working dog situations. Kelpies, Collies, Labradors.
It's not so much the tennis ball, but it's the game. When they go out and search for a device, being an explosive, when they find the device, they'll often indicate either by downing or sitting, and then the ball will come in, and then the handler will play the game with the dog. And because they love that game so much is why they go out and do what they do.
Looking around the school and talking to the handlers, it's clear that the dogs are more than just tools for the soldiers. They're companions, confidants, and a welcome distraction in a war zone.
He sleeps beside you, you're walking long distances, he's next to you, he's getting in the helicopter with you, he's there all the time, and they're great listeners too.
The loss of a dog can be felt just as acutely as the death of a human colleague.
Unfortunately, I did lose a dog overseas. She was tragically lost. She got run over during training. No fault of her own. You still think about it all the time. Took me a while to process, took me a while to get over it. This is Nova. We managed to have her cremated and I got to bring her back from Afghanistan.
Military working dogs have, in recent years, been commemorated in monuments and plaques. But now, the Defence Force is taking an unprecedented step. In a world first, the dogs are being awarded their own official service medals.
The Canine Operational Service Medal with Class Y Cat is awarded to retired EDD 400 Digger for service on Operation Slipper. Accepting the medal on behalf of Digger is Mr. Graham Ellis.
Bundy receives a medal for his service in Afghanistan. Explosive detection dog Shan is also recognised.
The Canine Operational Service Medal with Class Y Cat is awarded to retired EDD 459 Shan for operational service on Operation Slipper. Accepting the medal on behalf of Shan is Corporal Kane Killer.
It's a solemn occasion. I wasn't expecting to receive one for Nova. Sort of put me off a bit, but having a bit of the old crew around again, just having conversations with everyone, it's good.
This moment is the result of years of pushing from former dog handlers and their supporters.
So how did you feel when you saw the dogs being given the medals this morning?
A couple of tears there.
A special ceremony follows at the Australian War Memorial.
I often arrive at ceremonial events somewhat anxious that I've been unable to remove all of our golden retriever's dog hair, which in a naval officer's uniform is a constant hazard, but today I think I can probably get away with it.
One explosive detection dog is picked out for special mention.
Shan spent around 10 and a half dog years in Afghanistan, or around 18 months for the rest of us, working with Australian soldiers on some of the highest risk, most stressful activities of that period.
Every dog handler has the best dog there is. It's always fun banter between dog handlers. Most dog handlers don't count the things they find, it's the things they don't find. Nothing was found behind us and nothing functioned behind us, so no one ever found a cache behind where we've searched, or a vehicle was never struck an IED behind us. It's the best job in the world, I think. Getting to work a dog, keep people safe. And when you're out and about, people see the dog. They're like, oh, the doggy. And it's a taste of home. The medal looks amazing, I think.
Boy.
And it's just something we can say, yes, we recognise the contribution that animals, not just dogs, but animals make to defence. And I think that's really important.
In 2015, Shan retired. She now lives with Kane and has a pretty quiet life.
She's just being a dog, and that's what we kind of want. Then we take them home, we want them to relax. We want them to be in a home environment. We want them to sit on the couch and throw the ball outside. You know, they're just normal dogs then. An email will always go out, or someone will call somebody and I'll let you know that this dog's passed away, at 14, 15, 16, 17, some of the old dogs. Everyone gets like, that was a good dog. We'll have a beer for that dog. The same thing will happen with Shan. But that's miles away from me. That's 4 or 5 years, probably more, hopefully, if I keep her going. So, yeah.